Cody Carmichael and Dave Crosby sat at that piano. If you can play manually, or if you can play by putting piano scrolls inside of it. By way of decoration, I did mention that Mr. Hearst liked to collect a lot of different types of art and started very young. I started this project in 1919. However, the ceiling, which is 16th century Italian, he purchased this ceiling in 1909, 10 years before he even knew what he was going to do with it. And he collected a lot of ceilings. Most of what you're looking at is 16th century Italian. However, a lot of it is cast plaster. A lot of it is extension work made to fill the room. Quite often, Mr. Hearst would only get a small portion of the ceiling, or the ceiling he would get would not be big enough for the room, and so his craftsmen would have to do extension work, and you'll see a lot of that in the house when it comes to the ceiling. Probably the takeaway here is this fireplace. This too is 16th century. It is French. It came out of a chateau in Burgundy. It was originally purchased by Stanford White, one of America's best decorators and architects. Unfortunately, he died by his own hand. The fireplace was put up for sale, and Mr. Hearst was able to acquire it. He was very excited about it. He cabled to me a morning. He says, "I've got the fireplace. I hope that you will design a room grand enough to get it. What do you think?" She did okay. And again, this is what's called a mantle over mantle design. It's sort of a double fireplace. You see wild men again up there. And the way this would work is there would be a roaring fire down in this enormous firebox, and then this whole upper fireplace here, the ceramic, would heat up and heat this room very effectively. By decoration, I do want to point out the tapestries here and here. These are 16th century Flemish tapestries. We do know that they